Hey guys, how's it going? Today I'm going to show you how to make skeleton leaves which make beautiful subjects for macro photography. And making such skeleton leaves is really easy. All you need are obviously some leaves. I collected mine in the fall time, but in many locations, including southern Canada where I live, you can still find such leaves in the winter time, and they're going to work just as well for this project. Not all leaves work for this project, however, it is important that I have a strong structure, a strong skeleton, otherwise they'll just decompose completely. Well, if you can't find any fresh leaves, you can also use dried out leaves, which work just as well as long as they don't have any major cracks or damage. Once we've got our leaves gathered, it's time to place them in a bucket and fill it up with hot water. You can speed up the process of decompostation by adding some vinegar to make that solution more acidic, and once all the leaves are submerged, hold them down with a kitchen spoon or some sort of heavy object and close your bucket. Then it's time to store it in a warm location for the next 10 to 12 weeks, and once the time has come to open the bucket, you gotta prepare for a really bad smell, so I recommend doing that part of the project in the washroom with an open window. Anyhow, inside that bucket you'll find a brownish solution with the floating leaf skeletons inside it, and they're very fragile at this point and they still hold on to a lot of organic residue, so fish them out carefully and rinse them off, supported by your hands and fingers with very low water pressure in the sink. They are, however, very fragile at this point and they still hold on to a lot of organic residue, so gently fish them out and wash them off with low water pressure in the sink. Make sure you support them with your hands so they don't tear apart. And once you've got the major dirt off, it's time to place them on a smooth surface and gently brush off the leftover residue with a toothbrush. Be really careful as you do so. As I mentioned, they are very fragile and they'll easily tear. Once you've got all the dirt brushed off your leaves, it's time to rinse them one last time before placing them on a smooth and flat surface to allow them to dry into a flat shape. Give it another half hour or so for them to dry, and you should be able to pick up your own skeleton leaves and start taking creative macro shots. I'm excited to see what you come up with. Please post your images in the description below if you take any. If you enjoyed this video, leave me a thumbs up, and if you're looking for creative macro projects using skeleton leaves, check the link in the description below. That's about it. I hope you enjoyed this video. Have a good one.